Recent scientific experiments at Berkeley have demonstrated that the loudness of rock music can actually damage the ears. The Cream have 12 enormous loudspeakers, each one loud enough to fill the Albert Hall with sound. Jack Bruce explains why the music is so loud.
Suddenly, about two or three years ago, the ideas of dynamics and balance and things changed, because I think mainly because of these giant amplifiers were developed, you know, and it's just something that's in its infancy, really. It's something that affects the audience in a physical way as well as, you know, in a mental way. Whereas Julian Bream, it's purely mental. There's no... In an audience, especially in a small place, smaller than this size, that you get an actual physical feeling of the amount of volume that's coming out, and it's exciting.
But doesn't such enormous volume damage the ears and make you deaf?
Again, it depends. In a huge place like this, it doesn't affect you at all, because the sound just disappears into space. But in a small room, where we sometimes play, the sound is so compressed. You get a similar thing to when you're landing in an airplane. You know, you have to sort of, you know, blow through your nose and things to clear your ears. I've been told by a doctor that there is something in your ear when you're subject to this sort of amount of volume, it switches off. Apparently, you're unharmed by it. This is what he said anyway. Hopefully it's true.
Do you all, as very accomplished musicians, resent the comparatively low level of musicianship in most of pop?
I don't mind the other forms of pop music which aren't really going anywhere, which were just like an industry. I suppose it's providing work for a lot of people. I just do think that there's so much more to come from pop music than most people realize. You know, they could enjoy so much more from it if they knew.
But people don't know. They cannot consider that rock music may have something good to offer as well, for fear they may surprise themselves. What Eric Clapton, Jack Bruce, and Ginger Baker have done is to show that the form of much of rock music, 8-bar phrases, simple-minded harmonic progressions, and nursery rhyme lyrics, is ultimately unable to cope with the pent-up anger and musical aspirations of the young. To these aspirations, the Cream have given a language. And to this anger, the Cream have given a hope.